If you have a card website, or you're thinking about using Card or a similar website builder, then it's so important that you optimize this website so that you get the results that you want. And a lot of people, when they start off building a website, let's say for an app, and they're building an app sales page, they miss a lot of the key elements that are going to set them up for long-term success. So in this video, we're going to go over how to optimize your card website or a similar website for results. And this is incredibly important because a lot of this is low-hanging fruit. And the low-hanging fruit that makes massive changes to the end results. Because if your website is converting at a low rate, then it doesn't matter how much traffic you throw at it, you're still not going to get the results. Whereas if you can optimize your website with what I'm going to go through today, then it means the traffic that you send to your website is going to go much further. So let's start off with the general idea about what you want to do with a website. And this is optimization tip number one. So on your screen, you can see a landing page using a template using Card. Not my favorite design, because I would prefer a picture to the right and then have the text on the left, for example, but you get the general idea. And what we want to do first is to have a clear path for the first time user and lead them into taking action. So you can think about setting up your website for the first time user and just leading them into taking action. And I like to do it like this. Firstly, benefit-driven headline. Focus on the benefits, not the features. Then have a supporting statement with more benefits. Have some text where you talk about the problem people are having and the solution. And then a clear button to click here. Sign up. Now, this text is quite weak. You want to improve this a little bit. Sign up now. Sign up for our app, etc. So you want to include some benefits and just expand on that too. But the general idea is that you're having a minimal design. You're not setting up for people just to browse your website. Instead, you're getting them to take action. And this works for sales pages, for email opt-in forms, for free trials, etc. Even when it's a sales page as well, when you're selling some type of digital product. So that is the core of the website design you're going to be building with Card, to have that clear path so that someone takes action. Now, I read recently that 60% of people who visit websites do so on a phone. And that's probably not surprising to you. But this means that we have to optimize our website for mobile users. And Card does this automatically, but it doesn't always get it right. So if we click the mobile button over here, what we can see is, okay, we have the mobile user, looks pretty good, except for, I'm sure you can see it, this part here. So if we click on this part, it takes us over to the title here. But then if we click the style button here, the appearance button, then it takes us to this bit. Now, if you change the size, it's not going to do anything, okay? So what we want to do instead, let's put that back to where it was, scroll down, you'll see mobile. And we can change the mobile size so that it fits nicely into that box. Now, we might need to change spacing, letter spacing, etc., and margins. But what we can do is just to make sure everything is fitting okay as we scroll down the mobile, and then change things accordingly. So if we click on this text, we can scroll down and change the size on mobile over here. Click manual and then change the size. Say we want it bigger, smaller, etc. So that's a way to fully know that it's optimized for the mobile user. And one more tip with this, it's always good to get the whole picture within that first page of the mobile. So someone lands on here, you want to be able to have that button showing as well, so then people don't have to scroll. Now, I'm over here on Namecheap because our next tip is to get your own domain name for various reasons. Firstly, it's going to look more professional. Instead of having a something.card.co, you're going to have yourdomain.com. And it's very easy to set this up with Card. Now, you're going to need the pro account, but at the time of recording, it's $19 per year, not per month, per year. And that's going to include hosting for you. So you can get the domain name here, link it to Card. And it also means that in the future, if you use a different website builder, then you can just point that to the different website builder and the hosting over there. So it means that you can move around if you want to start using something like Webflow or Squarespace. And in fact, we have a video talking about Webflow versus Card if you want to learn the differences between those two website builders. Next, we're at Senja.io. Now, Senja is a testimonial tool that allows you to collect testimonials and reviews from different platforms, bring them all together, and create cool widgets and images so that you can share them elsewhere. Now, what we have here is how to add testimonials to Card, because adding social proof to your website is going to make a massive difference. Just think about the last time you were on a website and you're thinking, okay, this is looking good, but where are the reviews? What are people saying? Has anyone else bought this? Is this a scam? So what you want to do is to add any social proof that you have. Now, we made a video on Senja where we talked about how to use this tool. Now, you can use different tools. You can manually input your testimonials. But the idea here is that we can use different tools and then easily embed the widget onto your Card website. And it just goes through how you can do this here. And you can see it just has a full guide for you. And I'll leave this link in the description for you. Now, in a recent video, we talked about how to optimize your Card website for search rankings and gave you 5 tips for this. And this is going to help you get found in the search results when someone is searching for something that you offer. Now, I'm not going to go over everything here, but if we go back to the Card builder and we click this publish button and then go over to settings, then down here, we can do things like add Google Analytics to track people visiting your website. And then we can also scroll down and add any meta tags that mean what we might want to have here. Now, because Card is a simple website builder, the load times are going to be quite quick, but you're also going to want to optimize your images so you don't have large image files that take forever to load. So just little things like that are going to help you when it comes to speeding up the website for your users. And then go watch that video to learn more about SEO tips for your Card website. I'll leave a link in the description. But then the last tip is to say, include buttons throughout the page. So what action you want them to take, include this on your button and then copy it and paste it, maybe change the text somewhat to the different areas like this. I see people make the mistake of when people get down to the bottom, they're excited to join, but it's hard for them to join because there's no button here. So instead, people might think, oh, it's a small thing, but to scroll back up to the top, to then click the button, that journey just doesn't seem quite natural and fluid. So what we want to do is to ensure that we have plenty of opt-in buttons, sign-up buttons, buy now buttons throughout the page, whatever page that you're building, so that people can easily take action. And you're basically telling people, this is the action that you need to take next. You don't need to browse anything else. This is the button you need to click. And then you can continue your journey with us. So those are tips to help you optimize your Card website to get the results that you are after. Now, if you want to learn more about Card, then definitely check out our full review on the platform and also the playlist that we made where we talk about the different ways to optimize your site. For example, embedding videos, the SEO optimization techniques, and much more. We've also built a full sales page for an app using Card as well, so you can watch us do that. And then if you want to build something with no-code tools, then go to nocode.mba to learn more. You can get access to 60-plus curated courses and projects helping you how to build apps, websites, automations, and more. We go through tools such as Glide, Bubble, Webflow, etc. Now, if you've enjoyed this video, then please like and share it. Subscribe if you're new here, and thank you for watching. Bye for now.